Hello guys and welcome to Waterbeam. As of today, the Bajaj Discover has been removed from the website, but Bajaj says it will launch the BS6 version after some time. But still, we are going to be discussing why it didn't work well in the Indian market. So before we begin, subscribe to Waterbeam and let's get started. Until 2010, the Bajaj Discover had gained a lot of customers as it had already achieved that 5 lakh sales mark. Bajaj Auto, instead of sticking to just one category for Discover, they wanted a piece of every pie. With the Discover model, Bajaj stepped into each and every commuter category from 100 to 150cc. But the main problem was there were so many models launched and discontinued one after another. Everyone was happy when the new models came in, but discontinuing the model silently led to customers losing faith in the brand. While the existing owners got super angry as they had just bought a model and it got discontinued abruptly, it happened quite a few times. The strategy was to introduce new features and models every year for the Discover, which was quite cunning. The short-term strategy worked really well as they saw spikes in sales every time. But then it misfired in the long run as the sale dropped drastically after each and every spike. Let's look at a timeline perspective. In 2004, Bajaj launched the Discover with a 125cc engine and this was the first Discover. In 2005, they launched the Discover with a 112cc engine and they discontinued the 125. Now, in 2006, they got out of the 100cc segment and jumped to the 125cc bandwagon again. The 125cc bike gained a lot more profit and they claimed to deliver 100cc mileage from a 125cc performing motorcycle. In 2007, new stickers and colors for the Discover 125 came in, while in 2008, the engine got bigger and Bajaj launched the Discover 135 now. In 2009, Bajaj became a bit greedy as they launched the Discover 100 DTSSI. As customers were not convinced to buy higher cc Discovers that gave them the same mileage as the 100cc bikes. In 2010, Bajaj launched the Discover 150 while they discontinued the Discover 135 which people had just started accepting. In 2011, Bajaj relaunched the 125 as they played the demand supply game. While they also updated the Discover 100, they discontinued the 150 by the end of the year. In 2012, a major change happened. Bajaj replaced the Discover 100 with the Discover 100 ES4G, while the Discover 125 was replaced by the next generation design of the Discover as the 125 ST came in. Now, they might have realized their mistake, maybe a part of it, but they stopped discontinuing abruptly. In 2013, Bajaj launched a set of Discovers. They launched the Discover 100T, 100M and 125T, while the 125 ST was already there. The 125 ST was a unique motorcycle as it was the first Discover to get a monoshock, while the 125T was a simpler version of the ST without the monoshock while having the exact same features. Difference between the 100T and 100M was that 100M got a disc brake at the front, while the 100T got drum brakes both at the front and the rear, yet all the other hardware was shared between them. Instead of saying Discover 100 with disc and without disc, they kept making separate models altogether, adding a lot of confusion. You know, I just said a moment before that Bajaj understood to not discontinue abruptly, but they did it again. In 2014, they discontinued all the T models, Discover 100T, 125T, 125ST, while the 100M was still on sale, and they launched the 125M. You understand what mistake they just did? For Bajaj, M stood for disc brake, as the 100M got a front disc brake. They renamed the 125T to 125M and kept it as is, but said it is a newer model. By the end of 2014, they brought back the 150 in two different variants, the Discover 150S and the 150F. The 150S was a naked version while the 150F was a semi-fed version of the same bike with skinnier tires. As this was a 150, it was meant to have a monoshock because the 125ST with the monoshock was just discontinued. It was 2015 and the effect was evident as the customers had stopped trusting the brand for the Discover. The sales numbers for the existing models had dropped drastically to just 20,000 units. 5 lakh to 20, damn. By the end of 2015, they launched the simplest possible version of the Discover, the 125. No fuss anywhere around, standard and simple. And the first thing they did in 2016 is they discontinued three models of the Discover, the 100, 100M and the 125M. By the end of 2016, they understood that a Discover 150 is not gonna sell because the sales dropped to zero unit, forcing the company to discontinue that model too. So now the only model left in the Discover lineup was the standard simple 125. Before the BS4 effect would hit Bajaj, Discover brand was killed by itself. In 2017, Bajaj promised to keep the model as it is on sale with the necessary updates like BS4. But Bajaj being Bajaj, in 2018 they launched the Discover 110, while the 125 also saw some cosmetic updates like new LED DRLs. At a particular press conference in 2018, or should I mention it, it was the same press conference when the Discover was launched, the 125 and the 110. Rajiv Bajaj acknowledged the fact that Discover 125 was brilliant, but launching the Discover 100 was the biggest blunder in their product line. After the ups and downs, which were mostly downs, Bajaj made sure that they do not touch the Discover brand at all. In 2019, Bajaj did just one thing. They updated the 110 and 125 with CBS, which was mandatory. As the Discover did not qualify for BS6, being the least selling Bajaj motorcycle, it was discontinued and removed from the Bajaj website too. So this was a story where Bajaj Discover did not work that well in the Indian market. It was a marketing gimmick back then that backfired so bad that Bajaj lost its chance of being the number one brand. Just for your information, Bajaj is at number 2 and they are stuck below Hero MotoCorp even now. I hope you guys like this video, and I apologize if I did any mistake in any of the details of the models, because remembering each and every date was actually a task. If you guys want to see the reasons for failures of any other motorcycles, then do let us know in the comments below. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.